असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ज्योग्राफी एसजेएम कॉलेज कराड। आई फील वेरी ग्रेट प्लेजर टू इंट्रोड्यूस ऑनरेबल डॉक्टर डी एस जाधव सर, रिसोर्स पर्सन ऑफ दिस सेकंड सेशन। डॉक्टर जाधव सर हैज वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स, यशवंतराव चव्हाण इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस, सातारा। डॉक्टर जाधव सर हैज कंप्लीटेड हिज एमएससी विथ गोल्ड मेडल फ्रॉम बाबासाहेब आंबेडकर मराठवाडा यूनिवर्सिटी औरंगाबाद। डॉक्टर जाधव सर हैज ऑल्सो अवॉर्डेड इंस्पायर फेलोशिप बाय गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, न्यू दिल्ली ड्यूरिंग हिज रिसर्च वर्क। सर हैज गॉट थर्ड पोजिशन इन सर सी वी रामन प्रॉमिसिंग यंग रिसर्चर्स अवार्ड कॉम्पिटिशन ऑन द ऑकेजन ऑफ नेशनल साइंस डे। सर हैज पब्लिश्ड अ नंबर ऑफ रिसर्च पेपर्स इन डिफरेंट इंटरनेशनल रिसर्च जर्नल एंड ऑल्सो ही प्रेजेंट हिज रिसर्च वर्क इन नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंसेस एंड सेमिनार एंड ऑल्सो इन वर्कशॉप्स। डॉक्टर जाधव सर ऑल्सो वर्कड एज अ रिसोर्स पर्सन एंड डिलीवर अ गेस्ट लेक्चर्स इन वेरियस इंस्टीट्यूट्स एंड ऑल्सो सर हैज प्रोवाइडेड अ स्टैटिस्टिकल कंसल्टेंसी टू वेरियस रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट। सो वी गॉट अ डायनामिक पर्सनैलिटी इन फील्ड ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स। सो विद दिस आई कंक्लूड हिज इंट्रोडक्शन एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑनरेबल डॉक्टर जाधव सर टू डिलीवर हिज लेक्चर टू डॉक्टर जाधव सर।
ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच सर। गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। एम आई ऑडिबल टू ऑल?
यस सर।
ओके, just a minute, I want to share my presentation. Is it visible then?
Yes sir.
Okay, thank you once again to all. The title of the today's presentation is the statistics for research. Actually, in a field of the research, the data analysis is the must be and also most important, and for that purpose we need to the statistic techniques and tools. So statistics is the one of the most important part for as a researcher, and for that purpose today I want to the focus on the statistical tools which are mostly used in a research. Okay, start with the statistics definition. That is a general definitions. That is, the statistics is the art of the collecting, classifying, presenting, analyzing numerical data and interpreting result, as well as making conclusion about the system from which data was obtained. Here data is very important. Basically we can say that the statistics is deals with the collection of data, classification of the data, analysis of data and interpretation of data, and on the basis of the interpretation and the results we conclude the corresponding research or data and results. So here most important part is the data. So basically we first see the types of the data, which are earlier covered by the previous lecture, but here I have briefly introduced data types. So data types are divided into two parts. First one is the primary and then second one is the secondary. So secondary data is available which is already gathered from any NGO or any government society or any hospital or any website. So most of the data sets are Kaggle is the most popular site which have a more data sets, and any researcher for their research purpose they can use the second data from the Kaggle sites or any government sites or any general records or newspaper records. This data sets called as a secondary data sets. So primary data set need to be collect. So there are methods of collection for data. The most usually methods are experiment method and other one is a survey. Also observation is another method. So experiment, by conducting experiment we get the data, and on the basis of the data you can do your research. And another method is the survey. In a survey there are also two parts. The one is the census survey and other is the sampling. So census is deals with the population, whole population data. In India, each and every 10 years census is occupied. So populations, whole population study under the census, and part of the population is study under the sample. So part of the population means what is that? The subset of the population which is truly represented of the population is called as the sample. So here sample indicated that truly over the population. So truly indication is important as part of the sampling. So there are sampling methods, various sampling methods are available. We can use this sampling methods, and by taking the data or gathering the data, you can apply the statistical tools. So before starting with the data, we need to know about the types of the variables. So types of the variables are divided into two parts, the qualitative variables and the second one is the quantitative variables. So qualitative variables are deals with the characteristics of the particular variable, that is the categorical data. So for example, brand of the PC and the corresponding marital status, hair color are these example for the qualitative data. And the quantitative data, which is deals with the measurement of the data, that is mean the number of the corresponding temperature or anything, the number of children in the family. These are the example for the qualitative data. So qualitative data is concerned with the measurement. Qualitative data is concerned with the measurement, and quantitative data is concerned with the categorical data. So qualitative data are further divided into two parts, descriptive and continuous. So discrete data, which contain the whole numbers, in a shorter we can say that which contain the whole numbers, and basically discrete data is indicated by number of, that is mean number of children in family, number of strokes on a globe whole, number of TV sets owned. These are the example for the corresponding discrete data, or number of patients. These are example for the discrete data. And in continuous data, the numbers between the two numbers, all numbers between the two numbers we here consider, that is means we suppose in a temperature 10 to 20, so 10 to 20, all numbers from 10 to 20 we here consider, this called as a continuous. Here fraction part is considerable, and here measurement is that is means we say that the scale of measurements, here we use the amount of income tax paid, weight of student, yearly rainfall, temperature. These are the example for the continuous data. So discrete data and continuous data is very well known to all, because of the discrete is corresponding to whole numbers, this particularly denoted by the number of, and the continuous, which is included all numbers between particular two numbers. After that, the most important part, we know about the four level of measurements. So four level of measurements, which are defined as form as the nominal level, ordinal level, interval level, and ratio level. So why it is important to know about the four level of measurement? So on the basis of the level of measurement, you decide the which statistic states test or which statistic methods you can use for that particular data analysis. So before applying statistical method, you must be know about the level of the measurements. So one by one, we see here nominal level, data that can classify into categories. So only here category is important and cannot be arranged in any particular order. So in a nominal level, data is only arranged in category by example, eye color, gender, region. Only the category is important, none other, order is not important. In a second, ordinal, here what we get, data arranged in some order. So order is here important, but the difference between data values cannot be determined or are meaningless. Here order is important, but difference between the order is meaningless. What is mean that, for example, during a flavor test of four soft drinks like Jira Soda, ranked as number one, Sprite number as two, 7-Up number three, and Orange Crush number is four. So here we give a rank as a 1, 2, 3, 4, and here is order is important, but the difference between the order is a meaningless. That is mean number one rank and number two rank, the difference between the flavor is meaningless. So here order is important, and corresponding data which nominal level and ordinal level, the difference is the order is important in ordinal level. So by the name also you get the information about that particular level, and you can classify your variable as a corresponding level. Then the next one is the interval level. Here also similar to the ordinal level, with the additional property that meaningful amounts of difference between the data. Here what we get additional point, the difference between the data get a meaningful value. That is means there is no natural zero points. What is mean by natural zero point? So by taking one example here, see that temperature. In temperature, the difference between the temperature is important. And here zero temperature indicate that something temperature is present. So 0 degrees Celsius means there is a temperature is present. But in a ratio levels, if we take the zero income, that is means no income. If here ratio level zero is considered, then we say that the no income. So ratio level setup, in a ratio level, we take an example of income. So exactly difference between the interval level and ratio level, we can define by the taking an example of temperature and by taking an example of income. Because of that, whenever you collect the data and in a data point variables are classified at a different level, then you have a question marks which level we have here. So interval level is there or ratio level. So for that purpose, we can define this in a proper manner. In a interval level, there is no natural zero point, and in a ratio level, there is a inherent zero starting point. So here in a temperature also, one more thing is that we observe that the minus temperature is present and corresponding plus temperature is also present. So temperature is indicated, zero temperature is indicated, some temperature is there is available or there is present. But in a case of the ratio level, zero means none, there is no anything is available. So the interval level with an inherent zero starting point, differences and ratio are meaningful for this level of measurement. Here ratio also meaningful, that is means the difference between 10,000 and 20,000 is the same like as the difference between the 30,000 and 40,000. But in case of temperature, of 10 temperature to 30 temperature and 32 corresponding 50 temperature, the difference is a different in manner because of the temperature higher, 30 to 50 is indicated the higher temperature, and 10 to 30 is a maybe in a moderate form temperature. So a difference is meaningful, and ratio and differences are here indicated in a ratio levels, in a ratio level. So interval level, ratio levels and corresponding ordinal, nominal, these are the four levels we must be know about that. And then by depend on this, we can use the particular statistical test for particular variable. So summarize this particularly in the chart form: level of measurements, nominal, ordinal, interval, ratio. These are the levels we can differentiate in the form of the data may only be classified. And the example for the jersey numbers of football players and make of car. In ordinal, data are ranked. You rank in class, student rank in class, by taking a example for the ordinal data. Team standing in the 10 pack of 10 is also an example of the ordinal. Then after that, the interval, meaningful difference between the values, and the example for that, the temperature, and so one of other example is dress size. Then after that, the corresponding ratio, meaningful zero point and ratio between values, that is means number of patients seen, number of sales call made, distance to class. These are the example for the ratio. So nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio, these are the level of measurement. Again, here one question is arise, why does it matter? the types of data collection in a study determine the type of statistical analysis is very important. So types of data collection in a study determine the type of statistical analysis. How it occur? Here we can take one example. Can you compute average of car color? No, obviously not. Here we need to apply mode. Does it make sense of compute the average of educational experience? Not, obviously not. So these are the some examples which are related to corresponding statistical tells and techniques which are used. So we must know about the four level of measurements, and then after we go for the statistical analysis. So from this we move towards to the role of statistic in a research. So basically first one role is designing research. So for purpose of the research, we need to know about the statistics. What is mean by statistics? What is the statistical planning? All these things are very well known. Then we make a designing research in a very well manner. After that, for analyzing the data, you must use the statistical tools for the analyze the data, and on the basis of that, you can give your interpretation and results in a very well manner. After that, for draw a conclusion about research, we need to use statistics, techniques, tools, and methods. Okay, so we need to know about the statistics. Two major areas of statistics, that is, means statistical methods, are divided into two parts. First one is the descriptive statistics, and second one is the inferential statistics. So in a descriptive statistics, we find the central indices, which is indicated the raw data. Descriptive statistics, which give the idea about your raw data, and by using this, you can interpret some basic points of your research. And other is the inferential statistics. Actually, inferential statistics, it deals with the population on the basis of the sample. So sample is a subpart of the population, and on the basis of the samples, you can draw inference about the population. And for that purpose, inferential statistics is important. Also, inferential statistics divided into two parts. One is the estimation theory, and other is the testing of hypothesis. As a view, point of view of researcher, estimation theory is not important in case of the data analysis, but estimation theory is the base of the testing of hypothesis. So estimation theory, in estimation theory, as earlier I am saying that on the basis of the samples, we can conclude about the population. For that, we require the estimators and estimators statistics, which are depend on the samples. And on the basis of the statistic, we find the parameters which is related to the populations. So parameters and statistics relation can define in a estimation theory. So different properties of the statistics defined, and on the basis of that, we can conclude about the corresponding population. So in a view of the researcher, estimation theory is not important in other sciences, but in statistics, it is very important. Estimation theory, and estimation theory is the base of the statistic testing of the hypothesis. So here we focus mainly on a descriptive statistic techniques, and the second one is the testing of hypothesis, which is the mostly used in a research way. So starting with the descriptive statistics, it concerned with the development of the certain indices from the raw data. It summarizes collected classified data. Obviously, it is a summarization of the data points which are collected or which are gathered from the survey or questionnaire or any other form, or secondary data also you can use this descriptive statistics. So which measures is used in a descriptive statistics? First one is the measure of central tendency, which deals with the statistical average. We also call this is a statistical average. The second is the measures of dispersion. In measures of dispersion, mostly used is the standard deviation. And the next one is measure of symmetric, which is included as skewness, kurtosis. Skewness, positive skewed, negative skewed, symmetric, and kurtosis corresponding leptocotic, mesocotic, and platycotic. Then after that, the measures of relation. So in a measures of relation, here we study the bivariate data. If you deal with the univariate data, that is means single value, then you use the central tendency and the measures of dispersion. After that, whenever you go for to the bivariate data, that is X and Y, then you need to the take the relationship between the two variables, that is means dependency, independency. And if you want to the study more than two variables, we further go to the corresponding regression analysis. So correlation and regression, which are concerned with the measures of the relationships, which is a very essential for the researchers, and also other measures which are included, index number, and the second one is the time series. So one by one we discuss. So first one is the measures of central tendency. It is also known as a statistic average. And in a measures of central tendency, mean, median, mode are most the popular use. And then after that, the geometric mean, harmonic mean is a particular, in a particular place, we use the geometric mean and harmonic mean. So one by one, mean, it is also known as the arithmetic average. The mean is obviously the mean is found by using the sum of the all observation divided by total number of observation. Most widely used, appropriate only for interval and ratio data. This is appropriate only in a interval or ratio data. Here I want to say something. Every researcher have maybe three questions: why, when, and how. So why is very important, when is also very important, how you can get from the any softwares or other things. That is mean in a statistics you must be solved these two questions: why and when. Why mean is used and when mean is used. If you solve these two questions, then you get a use of appropriate mean or appropriate measures of central tendency or appropriate measures of dispersions and also appropriate test. So you need to solve the questions why and when. So here I am trying to give these answers of why and when. So here why is interval, when interval and ratio data is available, you can use the mean. And why, so finding the average, you can use the mean. The formula for the ungrouped data, obviously the sum of the all observation divided by the number of the observation. And in case of group data, when you have group data, as like this, suppose that you take the age groups 1 to 15 and then after that 15 to 30 and 32 up to something. So in that case, you need to the use frequency and class interval, that is corresponding mid value of the class, mid value of class. And by using this, you get the answer. Actually, this formula is not much important because of the availability of the various softwares in a market or in a website, or you have any student versions are available to use for the particular softwares. So this formula is not very much important, but whenever different types of data is occur in front of you, you need to the this data convert in a proper format, and then after that apply the particular softwares. Otherwise you not get accurate answers. The answers will be misleading to you. So before going to the softwares, you must be know about the formula. What is the difference between the grouped data, ungrouped data? The ungrouped data is indicated individual values series, individual series, and in a grouped data, there is a class interval and corresponding frequencies are available. The another type of the mean is the weighted mean. Also, it is a particular use of that weighted mean. The weighted average formula is used to calculate the average value of particular set of number with different level of weight. Whenever you have a levels of weight, then you use the weighted mean, must be used the weighted mean. So for that purpose, here I am taking one example. Is it corresponding to the corresponding result declaration? So you want to declare a result of final exam or a final result. So final result is based on the internal, mid semester and end semester. So internal have a 30% weight, mid semester have 20% weight, and end semester have 50%. Okay, then after that, for each exam, you have conducted separate exam which having of 100 marks. So particular students got 18 marks in internal, 75 marks in a mid semester, and 89 marks in a end semester. If here we use the directly mean, that is means arithmetic mean, the 80, 75 and 89, we get the mean approximately to the 81. We get the mean approximately to 81. That is means the value of this is arithmetic mean is 81. But here we lost the weight of the corresponding exam. Here we not taking the consideration of the weight of the exam, and it will be misleading to your result. So here need to the take a consideration of weight. By taking a weight consideration, we get the answer is 83.5. So this is the difference between the weighted mean and arithmetic mean. Here we go. So basically, whenever we need to the use of weight, you must be use a weighted mean, and the formula for that, the summation of weight into observation divided by summation of weight. So here we need to the multiplication of 30 into 80 plus 20 into 75 plus 15 to 89 divided by sum of the this weight, that is means 100, you get the final answer. So these are the particular applications for a particular means, that is a weighted mean. Whenever you taking the data in the form of the weight, you must be use the weighted mean. After that, the median. So median, very well known to all of you. So median is the value which is divide the data into two parts. The half data is less than the median, and above the median data is the obviously greater than the value of the median. So median is the positional value. Median is the positional value appropriate for ordinal data, also for highly skewed data. So what is meant by highly skewed data, we will see in the next slide. For the formula purpose, if n is odd number, then we use the median is equal to n plus 1 by tooth observation. Here the tooth observation is important. Simply we see that the example, if we take the n is equal to 15, then we need to arrange this data in an increasing order or in a decreasing, that is mean ascending or descending order. And then after that, we need to find the n plus 1, that is means 16 plus 2 upon 8, that is means 8 observation, 8th observation. So 8th observation value is indicated the value of the median. Sometime what happen, we directly take the 8 as a median. Sometime what happen, we directly take as 8 as a median, but not here. 8th value, 8th observation in your series is the value of the median. After that, if n is even, then we require to take the average of the middle two observation, that is means n by 2th observation, n by 2 plus 1th observation. Obviously, it also available in a software, so you can find the by using the different software's median value. But before the finding, you just know about the corresponding things, because of the cross validation is important in a particular research. So after that, the mode. Mode is the value which is mostly frequently occur in your data set. So it is useful in the studies of a popular items. Jar apala find karaycha astil tar apala obviously mode cha use karava lagto. So popular shoe size, popular cap, most demanded products which can be finded by using the mode. And mode is usable in appropriate measure for the central tendency in nominal data. When we have a nominal data, we must be use the mode. We must be use the mode. So mode is not a more stable because of the from sample to sample it vary. What is mean by for sample to sample? If you take the 1000 samples from a particular company and find the salary of that particular company mode most repeated salary, then we get the something amount. Then after the we change the samples 1000 of that company, they replace the other members, then we find the particular value, then we get the mode is in a different form. That is means sample to sample variation is occur in modes. So that's why mode is not a more stable value. But in a popular studies, we can use this mode for finding the most frequently used product or most frequently used items. In a many times, you can see in the online shopping, whenever you search the particular product, you get the some list of that product company wise, and then also one label is blinking on that particularly most frequently buying product as like. So most frequently buying product is indicated as like the mode is indicated as like the mode. Okay, then after that the geometric mean, also it is a particular use of the mean. It used for the average percent of change. It is used for the average percent of change, and the formula for that is the it is defined as the nth root of the product of the values of n times in a given series. Nth root of the product of the observations. By using this, we can find the geometric mean. And the purpose of this mean is the most frequently used application of this average is in the determination of the average percentage of change. Average percentage of change. If you want to find the particular average percentage of change, that is means if you want to the check your growth in a, as a particular share markets. If you invested 4,000 rupees and then what you growth you get, you need to the use the geometric mean for that particular purpose. So growth factor, we use the geometric mean. The geometric mean is more appropriate than the arithmetic mean for describing the proportional growth. Yes, obviously for the growth, arithmetic mean more appropriate geometric mean than the arithmetic mean. Then after the harmonic mean, also harmonic mean have a particular applications. It defined as the reciprocal of the average of the reciprocal of values items of series in a particular in the form the formula. We see that the reciprocal of the average of the reciprocal value, and it has a limited application particularly in a time and rate. Whenever you have a data related to time and rate, then you can use the harmonic mean. Then you can use the harmonic. It gives largest weight to smallest value and smallest weight to largest value. Obviously, it will give a weightage to inverse form. So largest weight to smaller value and smallest weight to largest value. Then after that, for understanding this application of harmonic mean, here we consider the one example. Suppose that you have four 10 kilometer segment, four 10 kilometer segment to your automobile trip. You drive your car. So first 10 kilometer drive as a 100 kilometer per hour. Second 10 kilometers drive as a 110 kilometer per hour. Third as a 90 kilometer per hour. And last one is 120 kilometer per hour. Here we want to find the average. Here we want to find average kilometer per hour. So what is the average speed? What is the average speed of the vehicles we want to find? If here we use the corresponding arithmetic mean, here again we get a misleading results. Generally what happens whenever you have get this like this problem, you use the arithmetic mean and calculate the answers and by using the arithmetic one. But it is wrong. Here we need to use the harmonic mean, and by using the harmonic mean we get the answer as a 103.8 kilometer per hour, and by using the arithmetic mean we get the answer as a 105 kilometers. So this is the difference between the harmonic mean and arithmetic mean. So for in a mean, you need to the use appropriate mean in appropriate way for in appropriate for appropriate data. So before that, applying this, we must be know about the different types of the means, and then after that particular application, by using these applications, you get the fruitful results from your result research. After that, next one measures is dispersion. So why need of dispersion? Obviously, from a central value, we not get exactly information of the data. So that purpose, we need to the study the dispersion. So here I am taking one example. Here we consider a student, three student A, B, C, and particular marks of the corresponding subjects. Where here we see that the average of the all students is the same. That is means we say that the all students are equally performed. But in form, if you observe the particular data, we look here, the one student have 35 mark in a particular subjects. That is means he is a fail in that particular student. So that is means it's not indicated the dispersion of the data. Central tendency, measures of central tendency not deals with the dispersion of data. So we require to the study the measures of dispersion. And measures of dispersion, the simplest measure is the range. By finding the range, here we get the first A student have a range 8, 20, and 40. On the basis of that, we can say that the A student is best than the other B and C, because it has a mean 55 and range is 8. That is, the dispersion of the data is very less. So generally, in analysis, we observe that X bar plus minus sigma. So X bar is a corresponding to central value, that is the mean, and sigma, which is related to the measures of dispersions. Generally, we can say that the standard deviation. Standard deviation. So most of popular measures of central tendency is a mean, and a second in a dispersion there is a sigma. So average failed to give idea about data which distributed around average. So measures of dispersion measures how spread out of set of data. So spread of data we can measure by using the measures of dispersion. So spread of data we can use by using the measures of dispersion. Obviously, by figure we observe that the how spread the data we can measure by using the measures of dispersion. So most important measures is range, mean deviation, and standard deviation. In a range, here only we take the two values. That is means the largest value and smallest value. Difference between the largest value and smallest value, by using this we find the range. But the range have some limitations. That's why we need to the find another measures, which is the mean deviation. Here we take the average of absolute value. That is means absolute value, only positive values consider. So also it have some limitations. Then we go for the standard deviation, which is the best measures of dispersion. Standard deviation. So one by one we say range. Obviously, the simplest measure of variability of is the range. Then after that, the range indicates the spread of the data from lowest to highest value. That is highest score minus lowest value. So although the range is easy to compute, it has a limited usefulness as a measure of variability, has a limited. What happened? By example, we have seen sometimes it misleading if the extreme upper or lower limits are atypical, not typical, abnormal of the other values. That is means here we observe that data set 1, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 15. Here 1 and 50 are not in a typical form. They are farthest from the particular series. That is means 3, 4, 5, 6 and the 15 and 1 are farthest from the particular value. So if the largest value and highest value is abnormal, then you get a misleading result from by using the range. So the its value is never stable, being based on only two values of the variables. That's why we need to the find mean deviation or the standard deviation. So this is the purpose of the particular corresponding measures. So in a mean deviation, we take the absolute distance from the mean, and by taking the average, we find the mean deviation. And here coefficient of the mean deviation. In a measures of dispersion, there are absolute measures and the other is the relative measures. Absolute it deals with the corresponding values. Here the unit is present, and for that purpose, we use the relative measures, which is the corresponding unitless. That means coefficient of mean deviation is a relative measure of dispersion and is comparable to similar measures of other series. So comparison purpose, we need to find a coefficient of mean deviation, coefficient of range, coefficient of standard deviation. These are the all corresponding to relative measures. And after that, the standard deviation, which is the mostly used. The standard deviation is the standard measure of variability in most statistical procedure and the most acceptable index of dispersion. It is the most widely used measure of a dispersion of a series variance. Corresponding standard deviation related variance, coefficient of standard deviation, coefficient of variation, these are the related measures of the corresponding standard deviation. So calculating the variance, there are two formulas. For a population purpose, we use the sigma square is equal to summation xi minus mu of sigma square upon n. Here n is the total number of population and mu is the population mean. And in a sample purpose, we use the summation xi minus x bar square n minus 1. So these small things in a difference. So whenever you use the population data, we use must be divided by n, that is total number of observation. And whenever we use the sample data, you must be divided by n minus 1. After that, the skewness. Skewness is indicated by the corresponding skewed of the data. So this is a negatively skewed graph, normally skewed, positively skewed. And then after that, the kurtosis. I'm skipping some parts because of the time is... Hello, madam. Hello. Ha, sir. Hello.
Jawan, sir.
Ha, sir.
Well, sir, काय
होतं? Yes.
हाँ, sir. हाँ, काय problem?
किती वेळ आहे माझ्याकडे?
आहे 12:20 पर्यंत करू शकता.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay. So because of that, I want to explain the testing of hypothesis. That's why I asking the same. So in a skewness, we generally check the corresponding skewed of the data. So it is basically based on the by using the skewness coefficients, we can see the graphical nature of the data. And on the basis of that, we can conclude the particular data sets. After that, the kurtosis, it deals with the thickness of the data, which is leptocotic, mesocotic, and platycotic, which are related to corresponding thickness of the data. Then after that, the next one measures is the measures of relation, which is very important for the particular as a research purpose. So in a univariate data, the analysis is carried out for the description of the single variable. In a bivariate analysis, the analysis of two variables simultaneously. In a two variables, we need to the check the If you need to the check the correlation between the or a relation between the two variables, then we need to find a correlation. And a multivariate analysis, the analysis of multiple variables simultaneously. So univariate data, bivariate data, and multivariate data are available for your study purpose. If you want to the study the simultaneously variables, two variables or more than two variables, then you need to the use the bivariate tools. Multivariate tools for a particular data set. So correlation deals with the corresponding it answers that does there exist association or correlation between the two variables, association or correlation, there is any correlation or association is exist in particular variables or not. It deals with the correlation, and for that we Karl Pearson coefficient, which is indicated by R, is used. And in a regression, it answers that is there is any cause and effect relationship between the two variables in case of the bivariate population, or between one variable on one side and two or more variable on other side. That is means here we find the functional relation, and functional relation here we find the cause and effect of the particular independent variable. Here dependent variable and independent variable. That is means also dependent variable called as a response and independent variables called as a regressors. So we find the response on basis of the regressors. So regressors effects on the corresponding response. So one by one, Karl Pearson coefficient of correlation. It is a simple correlation, most widely used method denoted by R. It is also known as the product movement correlation coefficient. It is also known as the product movement correlation coefficient. The value of R lies between +1 to -1. So what is mean by +1, what is mean by -1, and what is mean by other values where we get the interpretation. So give the interpretation, just we need to the draw a graphical presentation, and on the basis of graphical presentation on R values, you can conclude about that particular relations. That is mean perfect positive correlation, high positive correlation, low positive correlation, no correlation, low negative correlation, high negative correlation, perfect negative correlation. So what is mean by perfect positive correlation? In generally, positive correlation means if one value is increasing, then another value also increases. Then we say that there is a positive correlation. And if one value is increases and the another value is decreases, then we say that there is a negative correlation. So for that particular checking the relation between the two variables, here we use the that particular correlations, and by using this correlation, we can conclude that the relation is in the form of the positive, is the relation in the form of the negative, or also in a by using the Carl Pearson coefficient value of R, we also briefly given the conclusion that the highly positive correlation, low positive correlation, or low negative correlation, or high negative correlation. So it is also important part for the as a statistical purpose and also as a research purpose to interpret about the value. So positive value indicate that one value increases, other values also increases, and in a negative, here we say that the one value is increases, the other value is decrease. For that particularly, we say that if our income is increasing, then obviously expenditure is also increasing. This is the positive correlation. And the other one example is that if we increase the pressure, then volume of the particular is the decreasing. So as the pressure increasing, volume is decreasing. This is the type of the negative correlation. Then after that, the regression analysis. So in a regression analysis, there are two types of basically used a regression analysis, simple regression and multiple regression. In a simple regression, single exploratory variable and independent variable, single dependent and a single independent variable in a simple linear regression. And corresponding this equation of the is indicated by y is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x plus epsilon r. Epsilon r is the error term which is occurring. Obviously, here we need to check the assumption of the epsilon r, which is follows a normal 0 sigma square. So each and everywhere we need to use the corresponding assumptions and check the cross validation of that assumption to use the particular statistical tools. So in a using the simple linear regression, we require to the two variables. One of that is a dependent variable and other is independent variable. We can find the value of the dependent variable by using the independent variable. So in a prediction for prediction purpose, we can use the simple linear regression. Also, the second one is the multiple regression. So more than one exploratory variable, independent variable is present. So here one dependent variable is present, and more than one exploratory or independent variable or regressors are present for that particular. The model for that the same is represented in the form of the yi, which is equal to beta naught, beta 1, xi 1, beta 2, x 2, xp. Here xp are variables present, and ei is the error term. So example for the multiple regression, we can take an example of the yield of the particular crop. So yield of the particular crop is depend on the various factors. That is means the quality of the soils, fertilizer use, water conditions, and all the things which are affected for the particular yield of the soil or yield of crop. So that's why yield of crop is a dependent variable, and all other variables are independent variable. By using the regression, we can predict the values of that. Also here, another types of the regressions are presented, which is the polynomial regression, exponential regressions, which logistic regressions, as like the same regressions are present. The logistic regression is particularly used for the binary output. If your response variable is in the form of the binary, then you can use the logistic regression. Suppose that if you want to check the response of the COVID patients, yes or no, that is means positive or negative. That is, we have a response in the form of the binary, positive or negative. And the independent variables are various independence variables. So we can consider like health conditions at traveling, and then after that the corresponding previous medical conditions, and on the basis of that we can predict the corresponding another patient may be a positive or negative. For that purpose we can use the logistic regression also. Whenever we have a response in the form of the binary form, then we can use the logistic regression. Okay, after that corresponding other measures of descriptive, which is related to the index numbers, indicator of average percentage change. It indicates average percentage of change in a series of figures where one figure called as the base. So one figure is called as a base year, or a particular figure we take as a base year, and then on the basis of that we find the index numbers. Is assigned an arbitrary value of 100 and other figure are adjusted in proportion to the base year. So for finding the growth factors, we can use the index number. Most of the in population studies, index numbers are most of the use. Then after the time series analysis. Time series analysis is corresponding to as similar to the regression analysis. What is the difference between the regression analysis and time series analysis? In a time series, time factor is important. Here data is concerned with the time, and by depend on that we find the corresponding response. Also here we use for this model for the prediction, and time series analysis used in the corresponding time related data set. So the analysis of time series is based on the assumption that the successive values in the data file represent consecutive measures taken at equally specified time intervals. In a time series, the various factors are studied, that the, as like a trade analysis, seasonal variations, exponential growth, moving average methods, and other things also. So time series is also a predictive model, and we can use this for the prediction of the data whenever you have a data in the form of the time interval. After that, the next one is the testing of hypothesis. So also here most important part is the we must be choose a appropriate statistical test for a particular data set. So choosing a particular test is a very difficult task, because of in many research we found that in many articles or we found that the inappropriate choice of the test. So how we can choose a particular appropriate test? So here we see that. So firstly, how to select appropriate statistical test? Selection of appropriate statistical test is very important for analysis of research data. So purpose of the analysis, we need to the particularly choose the appropriate statistical test. So use of wrong or inappropriate statistical test is a common phenomenon observed in article. So wrong statistical test can be seen in many conditions, like use of the paired test for unpaired data. So what is mean by paired test and unpaired data? We will see in the next slide. So what is actually like, you know, is happen? Wrong statistical test can be seen in many conditions, like paired test for unpaired data, or use of a parametric statistical tests for data which does not follow the normal distribution. So in the test of testing, there are two types of the tests. The one is the parametric test and other is the non-parametric test. So on the basis of the data types or data types or data follow normal distributions or not normal distribution, on the basis of that we use the particular test for that particular data. That is means if the data follow the normal distribution, we can use the parametric test for that particular data. If data is not follow the normal distribution, then we use the non-parametric test. So before going to the testings, we must be know about the data distribution, and for that if you know about the data distribution, then we use the parametric test, which is included t test, T-test, Z-test, as like F-test, ANOVA, and this of variance. And in a non-parametric test, median test, run test, Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, as like Kruskal-Wallis test. These are the related to corresponding the non-parametric test. So for a particular data set, we want to check the normality. We use the QQ plot, or by simply by using the graphical also, we can conclude that the data given is a normal or not. So basically, whenever we want to use the test, we must be check the assumption of that particular test, and then go for that particular test. So because of the ability of why this happen to choose a inappropriate test, it is happen because of the valid ability of the different types of the statistical softwares. As earlier I am saying that the different types of statistical softwares are available to analyze the data, but perform the statistical test become easy by using the softwares. The statistical test performing is very easy, but selection of appropriate statistical test is still a problem. So proper selection of the test is very important, and on the basis of that you can give fruitful results to from your research. So what is the steps required for the selection of the appropriate test? Selection of appropriate statistical test depends on the following three things. The first one is the what kind of data we are dealing with. So what kind of data we are dealing with, that is means the level of measurements, which level of measurements you have. So variables which you have, that is means continuous, discrete, qualitative, quantitative, then after that levels, nominal, ordinal, interval, ratio. So must be you know about the which level of measurements you have the for particular data. Then after that, whether our data follow the normal distribution or not. So second one thing is that the data is follow normal distribution or not. You know, generally here we use the QQ plot method, or by using the graphical representation histogram, you also check the corresponding normality test. Also Kolmogorov-Smirnov test is available for the to check the normal distribution, and another also by using the PP plots. By using this test or this graphical presentation, you can decide the data is follow a normal distribution or not normal distribution. Then after that, the what is the aim of the study? So aim of the study is important to for the choose the corresponding test. So these are the three things which is related to the appropriate selection of the test. So data types, you must be know about the data. Then after that, the normality assumption. Then after that, the aim of the study. So in details, we see here what is the aim of the study. So this is the third prerequisite of selection of the appropriate statistical test. What we want to compare, first one, what we want to compare, whether we want to compare the drug with placebo, or our aim is the corresponding the drug compared with the placebo, or we want to compare effect of intervention by comparing pre-invention endpoints with post-invention endpoints. That is means if you want to the after and before, that is before and after effects, that is means the particular medicines, effect of the medicines, if you want to check the effect of the medicines, so we need to the data before taking a medicine and after taking a medicine. That means before and after data is available. So you must be clear about that, the what we want to compare. There we want to compare a drug with placebo, or we want to compare the after before effects. So if a research is clear about all the three questions mentioned in the previous text, appropriate statistical test can be selected. So basically three things are very well clear to researchers to select appropriate test. First one is the data, second one is the normality, and then after the aim of the study. So these three things are understand by using one example. To understand it better, an example has been discussed. Incidence of tumors observed in a control and treatment rats. So here two groups, one is control group and second is the treated groups. So control groups, in a control groups, one rat is affected by tumors out of 40, and in treated, six rat is affected out of 40. So which type of data we have? Anyone can give answer? आपल्याकडे कोणत्या पद्धतीचा डेटा आता अवेलेबल झालेला आहे? आपण आता इथे एक्सपेरिमेंट जो आहे तो करस्पॉन्डिंग रॅट्स रिलेटेड करत आहे. ट्युमर्स प्रेझेंट आहे किंवा नाही हा आपण चेक करत आहे. एक कंट्रोल ग्रुप घेतलेला आहे, दुसरा आपला ट्रीटमेंट दिलेला एक ग्रुप आहे. ग्रुप्स मध्ये 40 ऍनिमल्स आहेत, दोन्ही ग्रुप मध्ये इक्वल ऍनिमल्स आहेत. त्यातील कंट्रोल ग्रुप मध्ये एका ऍनिमलला ट्यूमर ऑब्झर्व झालेला आहे आणि करस्पॉन्डिंग सेकंड मध्ये आपला सिक्स ऍनिमल्सला ट्यूमर ऑब्झर्व झालेला. तर हा डेटा टाइप कोणता आहे, आपल्याला कोणत्या टाइपचा डेटा मिळालेला आहे, लेवल कोणती आहे? फ्रॉम पार्टिसिपेंट्स आपला डेटा सेट जो अवेलेबल होता, जोपर्यंत आपल्या डेटा सेटचा टाइप लक्षात येत नाही तोपर्यंत आपल्याला त्याच्याविषयी डील्स करता येणार नाही.
नॉमिनल डेटा.
यस यस, गुड. सो हियर वी गेट अ नॉमिनल डेटा. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ वी विल क्लियर अबाउट द नॉमिनल डेटा, देन आफ्टर दॅट हियर वी नो नीड टू चेक द नॉर्मॅलिटी. नो नीड टू चेक द नॉर्मॅलिटी अँड एम ऑफ द स्टडी, ऑब्व्हियसली वी वॉन्ट टू द comparison between the controls and treatments. So here we get a data form in the as like control group, treatment group, and tumor is present, yes and no. That is means is a form of the contingency tables. It is a form of the contingency table. We get data in the form of the contingency table. So obviously for that purpose, three questions answers we get. The first one is, what is the aim of the study? Our aim is to compare incidence of tumor between two unpaired groups, which control and other is the treated. Next one, what kind of data we are dealing with? Obviously, in the present study, the data type is a nominal data. And the next one is whether our data follow the normal distribution or not. Obviously, there is no need to check the distribution is a nominal data. They follow a chi-square distribution. Because of the contingency form, we get a chi-square distribution. So here, which test we need to use? Obviously, here is a qualitative data. We can move towards to the analysis. And by using the Fisher test, this is a Fisher test which is used for the small samples to compare a categorical data or a contingency table. So Fisher test here we use. If we have a large sample, then here we use the chi-square test. For chi-square test, we require to the each and every cells have a more than 5 values. So more than 5 values is required for the particular cell in a contingency table to use the chi-square test. So this is the limitation of the chi-square test. And for that purpose, here we use the Fisher's test, which deals with the qualitative data in the form of the contingency table. So next one, we will see the one by one test, t-test. So testing inference about the population means. Population means there is here a single observation here we take. Here we take a single observation. We use the t-test. And for the testing, we require the 6 steps. The first one is set a alpha value, that is level of significance. Then after that, the state a hypothesis. Here null hypothesis and the second one is alternative hypothesis. Then after calculate the test statistics, that is the sample value. We want to calculate the test statistics. If we use the softwares, then we need no need to the worry about the test statistics. Directly we can use the p-value. against this we use the p value. Okay, then after that find the critical value of the statistics, that is means p values we compare with the p value and then of all with the level of significance. In a manual process we need to the compare the test statistics value and critical value, and in corresponding softwares we need to the check the p value and corresponding level of significance, that is means alpha value, level of significance, that is means alpha value, then state the decision rule and state the conclusion. These are the six steps which are involved in the significance testing. So after that the one sample exercise, here we take the samples. We need to first step the set the alpha level 0.05, then null hypothesis H naught mu is equal to 1000 and alternative hypothesis mu is equal to not equal to 1000. So alternative hypothesis is indicated that your test is one sided or two sided. If here we take the greater than or less than form, then test is in the form of the one sided. And if we take the not equal to, then the test is in the form of the two sided. So critical region lies in as a form of the two sided. So here critical region lies in the two sided. And whenever we use the corresponding one sided, so critical region is lies to one side. If you take left side, so alpha is lies between here. And in two-sided case, alpha by 2 and alpha by 2 as like this, the test are values are critical values are like. So here important that whenever we use the softwares, we want to give a one-sided test or two-sided test or right side, right tail or left tail. So for that purpose, here we check the alternative hypothesis. What is your alternative hypothesis? And on the base of that, you decide that the test is two-sided or one-sided, right tail or left tail. So then the SPSS result of that particular test, here we observe the two-tailed test. Obviously the p-value is 0.002. So p-value is less than 0.05. So corresponding it is a significant. It is a significant. Hence we reject H naught. That is means mu is not equal to 1000. Mu is not equal to 1000. We reject H naught. That is, we accept the H1. We reject H naught. That is means we accept the H1. That is mu is not equal to 1000.
Jadhav sir.
Hi, yes.
My kind request. Please conclude. Some other experts are waiting. Please.
So as like same two samples, t tester dependent. Sample t test, independent sample test. So dependent sample t test, so repeated measures are observed as like brothers, sisters, husband's wife, left hand, right hand, before, after data. So in that case we use the dependent sample test, and then after that the this is the SPSS process. Some examples which are related to the dependent samples, then corresponding example of BMI. So in the case of the this, here we take the hypothesis that mean of urban areas and mean of suburban areas equal or mean not equal. So for that particular test, here two samples, urban area samples and suburban areas are samples are here considered, and on the basis of that we find the results. Stepwise answers is here given. This is the independent types. This is the independent type. Then after the chi-square test, which is for checking the independency of the test, independency. Also, is there any relation between the living in a suburban area and living overweight before a WLTP? It's a work program for that particularly weight loss training program. Weight loss training program, and for BMI less than 25 and BMI greater than 25, we use the chi-square test. So basically, due to time restriction, I'm not able to explain this all this in a briefly, not in a well manner, but just I want to give idea about that dependent and independent test, t-test. Dependent, that is means that your sample observations are dependent. In case of that, your measures is before after, that measures is same and samples are same, just you take the observation before and after. And in independent, your samples are different, that is means in a previous example here we see that the mean of the urban areas and mean of the suburban areas, if you want to the check as like that, then you use the corresponding independent t-test. Whenever you want to the independency of the attributes, independence of the attributes, that is means we, whenever you deals with the qualitative data, then we use the chi-square test, then we use the chi-square test, and that purpose we use the chi-square test. So appropriate choice of the test is important, and the testing for that particular chi-square test is as like this: living an urban area and being overweight are independent, living in an urban area and being overweight are dependent. So this is a types of a hypothesis which is used for the particular chi-square test. Okay, if any questions, please ask.
I request to the participant, if you have any doubt or any question, so raise your hand, please. Yes. Dr. Yogita Pote, welcome. Ask your
good afternoon, Dr. Zadav sir. Very interesting and knowledgeable session you have given. Thanks a lot, sir. I have one question that regarding what is the difference between the two methods, that is correlation and that is regression analysis.
Yes, okay, thank you, madam. Good question. Correlation, just we find the relation between the two variables, and in a regression, we find the functional relation between the two variables or between the one variable and more than two variables. There is a difference, is a functional relation, that is means the particular variable is affected or caused on a other variable is finding in a case of the regression. In a regression case, we define a equation as like y is equal to, suppose, a plus bx. It is nothing but the regression equation. So x is an independent variable. So x is a independent variable and y is a dependent variable, that means your response. So how much x is contribute to y is in the b, is in the b. B is a intercept, b is a intercept. So this is a functional relation. Here we call it as a regression. Here we call it as a regression. And whenever we take the x and y correlation, r only, here we find the r, it indicates a degree of relation. R is indicate the degree of relation, and here we find the functional relation between the variables. So this is a basic difference between the regression and R. Got it, madam?
I think he is not answering, but
okay.
Sir, thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
I think we discussed near about 1.5 hours.
Yes, so, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. I express my deep sense of gratitude to Dr. Honorable Dr. Zadav sir for his highly knowledgeable thought and for having progressive all about statistics in our research work. Dr. Zadav sir deeply pointed out all the importance of statistical techniques which is used in our research work. I think the statistical analysis gives a meaning to the meaningless numbers and thereby breathing life into a lifeless data. So, sir, your thought at the event really proved to be great motivation for us to improve our knowledge in our research work and in our statistical knowledge. It was very pleasant experience to listen to you. On the behalf of organizing committee of this 1-week faculty development program, and also on the behalf of Sadhguru Gargi Maharaj College, Karad. I thank Dr. Dadav sir. Thank you, one and all. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. I am also thankful to organizer to give me such a nice opportunity to interact with the researcher. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, sir.